The word for today is re-engineered, and that's exactly what the new generation of Kaba Peaks Preferred is all about. You're going to be very pleased with what Kaba has done with the new Peaks Yale-style large format interchangeable core. They've taken it to the next level, so let's dig right in. Our plan of attack is to look at the visuals of that particular core. Then we're going to talk about the improvements. We're going to look at the components that are involved. We're going to do the math, which is very simple, and then we're going to combinate and test our cores. Now, as far as the new generation is concerned, one thing you could notice is that on the plug face, there is a P representing preferred. These cylinders have been re-engineered for quality and assembly. The plug has been changed and redesigned for assembly improvements. Now, the Yale bottom pins will use the A bottom pins in the pin kit, which is the same as an SFIC. And that includes the wafers, which would be the master pins, the control pins, and the top pins. They would be the B pins, also used in small format interchangeable core. The pin stack, though, will total 26 and will be a uniform pin stack. These are large format interchangeable cores, sometimes known as removable cores. As far as the components are concerned, we have a spring retainer, the 3425. We have an SFIC system of pins that we will be using. The question always comes up, what about the control chambers? Well, there are 6 control chambers, unlike a traditional Yale-style core. Now, there is no extended tip on the control key. It runs just like SFIC. The patented Peaks chamber, well, the bottom pin is already seated at the factory, so all you're going to have to do is enter the preferred Peaks top pin in that chamber, and there will be no additional pin to fill that balance of that space. Now we're going to take a look at the components table to see what these parts are. This is our Peaks preferred components table. If you look across here, you'll see the Yale-style core for large format. Here are all the components that we will use, and especially note that we're using small format A2 pins for bottom and top. Before we combinate, the first thing we do is our math on paper. And that's very easy, and I'm going to show you exactly how to do that. In this particular system, we are using a 26 pin stack total. That means each pin stack will be equal across the core at a height of 26. We are using an SFIC system, and in this case, we're using A2. We are always going to go tip to bow, or in other words, from the back of the core to the front of the core, and that goes for cylinders and keys. So now we're ready to start doing the math so we can combinate later. Here we have our coded pinning chart for our Peaks Yale-style large format interchangeable core. I want you to notice that our pin stack height will be 26 in each chamber. What we do first is we enter our key biddings. We have the control key bidding on top in red. Our top master key bidding is written in green, and our change key bidding here is written in blue. Below the thick line are the pins that will go into the cylinder, and those pins will be calculated starting with bottom pins and master pins. Now, we have 6 chambers. This is an X-ray view of the core down here. So we're going to start with our bottom pins and master pins. And it's a very simple way to do it. If you see this thick line right here, that separates the two operating key biddings from the control key bidding. We're not going to be concerned with that bidding right now for the plug totals. So we look at these two numbers. So the first thing we do is we look at the top master bidding and the change key bidding. Now, we see the smaller number, and that's a 3. That automatically becomes the bottom pin. The difference of those two numbers, in this case, is 2. That number becomes our master pin. Let's take a look at that in chamber 2. Our two biddings are 9 and 5. Our smaller number is a 5. So that goes down automatically as our bottom pin. The difference between those two numbers is a 4. That becomes our master pin. It's very simple. Let's do one more. A 7 and a 3. The 3 is our smaller number. That becomes our bottom pin. The difference between those two numbers is 4. That becomes our master pin. We do the same thing for the rest of the cylinder. Now that we've calculated bottom pins and master pins, we're going to go up to the top pins because this is your system, you have all the information, and we know it's accurate. So how to figure out the top pins is very easy. In an A2 system, for small format, we would normally use 13 minus the control cut would give you the top pin. But remember, we are using a 26 pin stack, which is 3 increments larger. So we change the 13 to a 16, and it will work perfectly. 16 minus the control cut will give you the top pin. So, using that simple formula, 16 minus 7 will give you 9. Again, 16 minus 7 gives you 9. In the third chamber, 16 minus 9 gives you 7, 16 minus 6 gives you 10, etc. So now we have everything here except the buildup pins, also known as the control pin. Now, there are two ways to do it. Those of you who love formulas can follow the standard conventional formula for the buildup pin, also known as a control pin. It's control cut plus 10 in the A2 system, minus your plug total, which is right here, plug area. That gives you the buildup pin, or the control pin. If you like to do it that way, fine, but there's another way that's even easier if you prefer. We already know our bottom pin and master pin totals 5. We know our top pin totals 9. That's 14. If we just take our total pin stack minus the 14, that leaves us with 12. And that gives you the buildup pin. Either of those two ways will get you to the same place. Let's do chamber 2. We know 4 and 5 equal 9. We know the top pin is another 9. That is 18. We subtract 18 from 26, and we have 8. And the third chamber, we know our plug total here is 7, plus the top pin 7 gives us 14. Subtract that from 26, it gives us 12. Either formula will get you to the same place. So now we've calculated all the numbers we need to drop the pins into our core. But first, we have to lay out the components so we'll be ready to do just that. Here we have the Caba Peaks preferred pin kit for A2 system. Let's take a look at how it's put together. Very simply, the bottom pins are all at the bottom of the kit. We have the J pins in this section here, and we have the A bottom pins for some of our cylinders in this section. All of our wafer pins are here, which are the B pins, and they will run from a 2B up to a 19B. We have our retainers at the side, and we have retainers over here, springs, caps. So everything we need is in the kit itself. Now that we've done the math, we're going to lay out our components so everything is ready to use when we combinate. You could use a pinning block or a pinning mat such as this, whichever you're comfortable with. Today I've loaded them onto a pinning block. Let's take a look. All of our bottom pins are across here, chambers 1 through 6. Our bottom pins, master pins, control pins, and top pins. At the very top, we have our springs. Over to the side, I have our retaining clip. Now, we're ready to take those and drop them right into our cylinder, starting with the bottom pins. For our combinating procedure, we will pin each chamber individually before moving on to the next. We are going to go left to right, or back of the core to the front of the core, which equates to tip to bow. Now, you may have noticed I have an orange stabilizer tool here. What this is doing is lining up the plug, the sleeve, and the shell so the pins will drop in very easily. Now, in order to combinate, you could use either your fingers or a pair of tweezers, or both. It's your choice. But be careful to watch for the number 4 pins when you drop them in, because at times they may go in a little crooked. As far as the Peaks patented chamber, the bottom pin is already placed into that chamber by the factory. All you need to do is put the patented top pin in that chamber, and no other pin above that is necessary. So right now, we're going to start with the first chamber, the bottom pin. Now we're going to get the master pin for chamber one. Now the control pin. Now our top pin. Now I'm going to use our ejector pin just to push down to make sure everything's seated properly. Yep, that feels great. Now we'll go on to chamber two, bottom pin. Master pin for chamber two. Control pin for chamber two. And our top pin for chamber two. Make sure they're seated. And this is how you would continue to combinate the rest of the cylinder until you reach the end of the pin stacks. The next thing we want to do is make sure that our pin stacks are equal height. And if you look inside from the top, you can see that all stacks are equal at 26. So now you're good to go. We can take our springs and insert from the back of the core to the front. Now that all of our springs are seated, the next step is to take the spring cover and put it in place with our finger. Now that we've done that, we can test with our keys. We'll start with our change key. Very smooth operation. Our master key, also smooth. And our control key, perfect. The next step is to seal the spring cover. Staking tool. Sealed. For our final test, we have both of our Peaks Yale-style cores in a key retainer device. We see the top master is locked into place. We take our Peaks change key and place it into the cylinder, turn, and we can remove our master and do our business within the facility. We then return our Peaks top master key into the KRD and remove the change key, and we've now tested and found out that our Peaks cores work beautifully.